Wan 2.2 Animate is an exciting new open source video model that has the local video generation community talking. You can now create captivating short animations if you have the GPU to run it. Don't worry, I don't either. That's why I will walk you through the steps to get up and running on Vast.ai so we can start animating today. Let's get into it. So to kick things off, I'm over at deploy.promptingpixels.com. So this is an app that I built. Now, if you're rolling your eyes thinking this is an advertisement, it is not. This is completely free and will remain always free. But basically, this creates a provisioning script so we can kind of have everything set up on Vast automatically and everything within the appropriate file structure to make it a little bit easier to start and destroy instances. So I'll kind of walk you through it here really quick. So I'm going to use a preset configuration of Wan 2.2 Animate models with custom nodes. So I'm going to click load here. So basically what this is doing is going to install the latest version of ComfyUI onto our instance. And then if I click on next here, it already added all the models for us in order to use Wan 2.2 Animate. So the required save tensors file, LoRa, text encoder, and so on and so forth, and it's all mapped to the appropriate directories. Now, I do need to put in a Hugging Face token, and you can get this within your account here to basically download the model files. Now that that's set, we can see it's valid. I'm going to go over to the next step here of setting up the custom nodes. So I already have 4 custom nodes selected. Again, this is all already added with our preset configuration in order to use Wan 2.2 Animate. Next, we'll go over to configure GPU. So you can use either Vast or RunPod. Personally, I prefer Vast as it's cheaper and they have a better GPU selection. So I'm going to toggle this over to the max plan and then select the RTX Pro 6000S. And the reason why I'm selecting this GPU is it has a staggering amount of VRAM. You can see 96 gigabytes total. So that is more than enough. This card typically retails for about $10,000 or so, and I'm only paying $1 per hour. So much more affordable and budget friendly. So this is my Vast API key. So you'd want to put in your own Vast API key to deploy that. And then once I click on Launch Workspace here, it'll basically create the provisioning script. So then Vast can read that and then create the machine or the instance with all the appropriate downloads. So I'm going to click on the Open Vast AI console, and then I have my GPU available here. And now we have everything available to us to start playing with Wan 2.2 Animate, and it has already downloaded all the necessary files. So all I need to do is just click on Applications and then over to ComfyUI, click on Open Application here. Okay, I'm in ComfyUI here, and I'm just going to go down to View, Browse Templates, and Search Animate. And as you can see, there's Wan 2.2 Animate, and we will just simply click that. Now you'll see some missing models notifications here. Don't worry, we have them all installed. These are just different names, so I'm going to close that notice. Now, ComfyUI is very intimidating. I still get lost in it all the time, even after using it for a couple of years. Luckily, this workflow is very well organized. So I'll kind of walk you through it and kind of show you some of the tweaks that we can make along the way as we kind of get into the nitty-gritty of this workflow. So as you can see, there's several different groups. We have the video size. We'll leave this at 640 by 640 for now, but we'll do some larger animations later on. We have our load models group, then we have a prompt along with a reference image. So this is going to be, say, a static image that you want to animate. And then we would have our original video, which is kind of also known as like the driving video. So what's going to be causing the animation goes through a control net type of feature here with a DW pose estimator, one for the face and then one for the body and hands. Then it goes up to here to the character mask and background video processing. Now, this is largely optional if you want to mask a character as far as kind of like a canny outline, if you will, of the character, or have the same background as your original video, you would make those adjustments or keep this as is here within this group. And then once you scroll down, you'll see the sampling and video output group. This is basically just where all the processing happens, and it goes through the K-sampler and the Wan Animate 2 video nodes. And if you want to extend an animation, you can basically copy and paste this group multiple times and daisy chain them together. So we're going to leave everything at the default for now. And so I will bring in a reference image, or first let's just go through the load models. So as you can see, once I click on that, we'll have our new model name. So that's why it was yelling before. This is the CFG step distill. So I'll make sure I change that there. The relight LoRa is there. We'll leave the sampling the same. For the text encoder, we'll change that. Clip vision H, and then the VAE. So I'm going to change this prompt of a colorful marble statue is waving. And then I'm going to bring in my reference image here. I have this image I created in Midjourney, and then my driving video. And here's a short 3-second video of me just waving for demonstration purposes. Now we have the DW pose estimator. So I'm more of a visual learner, so I'm going to bring in a preview image so you can kind of see what's going on. And then I'm going to do the masking here in just a minute. So let me click run and then stop. That way I can see the character here, so which is me. So if we want to basically bound the video to my canny outline, we can just simply shift click onto here and add a bunch of different markers along the edges. I'm kind of going quick here, but just to give you an idea of what's going on. Okay, cool. And so if we wanted to see what this mask looks like, we can do a preview of the mask. I'll unbypass those. And then back to the DW pose estimator. I won't go through this too long, but you can see it's outlined of my face in the video only, and then in all the key points, and then the pose for my body and hand here. I'll run the entire process again. And so it's going to basically take that image as a reference along with me waving and create a short form animation. We'll go up to the mask preview here. And so you can see here's a rough outline of my body. That's what's being passed as the mask for that. And then in the background here, we can see it's not perfect. I could have probably been a little bit better on my selections there, but you can see everything in this background will remain within the video. So after incredibly 39 seconds on this beast of a GPU, we have our animation. So there we are. We got definitely some odd things going here, but overall pretty good. There's a marble statue of me waving. The hand could use a little work instead of being a marble statue. So that's it. That's Wan 2.2 Animate. So let's make a few tweaks to this. So I'm going to take off the character mask and the background. Okay, so without the character mask and the background video, here is our new output. This looks really, really good, especially compared to our reference images. It keeps the likeness of this reference image way better without both of those options applied. Really, really cool. All right, let's extend this video now. So I'm going to unbypass all of these and then just run the sampler again. So now we have a 9-second video of me, or a marble statue, if you will, that's referencing my video waving. And so very awesome. It pulls it together quite nicely. So here's the original video, a little larger resolution, and it's good, but we want to really amp up the quality. So in order to do that, we are going to change this resolution to a much higher resolution. So 1280 by 720. Now this will definitely increase the inference time. So you always want to make sure that you have a GPU that's available to handle that. So I will go ahead and click on run here. All right, so that just wrapped up after about 4 minutes, and here is our output video. So we can see the resolution looks a lot nicer. It's a little bit more crisp. We could even bring this through an upsampler, and it's also got this nice widescreen format and matches my original animation much better. So that's it with using Wan 2.2 Animate in ComfyUI. Now, if you have any questions, please feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.